We are back in Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. I'm excited about this. It's been a while. This expansion took a while to work on, which makes sense because it's supposed to be huge. So a lot of you weren't subscribed back when this was going on. So just so you know, in the description, you can find a playlist for The Witcher 3 up to this point. It, as of right now, was 141 episodes because there's 120 just for the main game itself and then another 21 from the expansion Hearts of Stone that came out a few months ago. And now we're here to take on Blood and Wine, which I think is supposed to be 2 to 3 times larger than Hearts of Stone. Like, it's supposed to be a really big thing. And I'm happy to be back, because I love this little universe we're in here. I missed you. I missed you, Geralt. Let's go murder things. Okay, so I just loaded into the game, and I just opened up the menu just to take a look at it, and things immediately look different. There's a big, bright experience bar on top of the screen saying 2,000 and 2,000 level 36. Did I max out the experience? Do you cap it at level 37? Actually, I'm not sure, but that giant glowing bar definitely wasn't part of the expression before. How do these menus look when they load? Whoa! They just flat out revamped the menu system. This looks different for sure. The text is swifted up a bit. There's like color gradients here and there. How about the inventory? Hello. Yes, this is different. Interesting, and it's that I understand what tabs are. Thank you. All right, you can toggle between large and small descriptions of items by holding the left stick. Turn off the item descriptions by pressing left stick. You can see how an item. Ooh, if you press square on items, you can actually find out how they look on Geralt, like as a preview window. You can sort things with right stick. There's a lot going on here. Hold right trigger to go to statistics panels. So if I press square. Oh yeah, there it is. So it just loads it up on their character to see what it looks like. That's interesting. This is different. This is not how the game worked before. This is cool. So they revamped how the entire screen is even shaped. You can see my vitality information, my toxicity information. You can see what trophies and everything are equipped. Most of the information of the equip screen is mostly similar on the right side over there, but it's presented in a different layout. There's a nice solid character in the middle of it that I actually don't remember for sure whether or not he was there in the screen before or not. Admittedly, it's been a while, but you have weapons and armor in separate categories, so there's... Oops, I pressed alchemy on instead. Unfortunately, I'm still on PS4, so the loading of the menus is rough. But yeah, ooh, look at this. Everything's so nicely sorted. And that nightmare menu in particular. Alright, change of pace. They've been actively patching their game. That's cool. That's always good to see. Oh, this is nice. There's nice little color-coded sections for each quest category. And then when you click on one, you can walk into it, and then while you're in the middle of it, you can hit triangle to close that whole tab, so you don't have to navigate back to the top of the tab to close it again. So you can quickly change your mind about where you want to be. This is fantastic. Going through the character screen for the talents, it doesn't seem to have particularly changed as far as how it functions. It's just very, very bright and colorful, and probably a little more clear in how it works exactly. Showing this vertical succession of skills and going from tab to tab like that. Oh yeah, a lot of visual changes here. And then, of course, when you're going through your skills themselves, there's very, very clear indication with very bright colors whether or not stuff falls into a certain color category, which affects the multipliers going on here. And yes, for those of you that aren't initiated, yes, I do have a spellcasting, a sign-oriented character. I started my playthrough on the second highest difficulty and then upped it to the highest difficulty midway through the main game because it got too easy. And I'll be sticking with the highest difficulty throughout this expansion, probably. Might bite me in the ass a little bit as I try to get back into the rhythm of things, because I'm probably a little rusty, but we'll figure it out. I look forward to my pyromancy ways continuing. As many such days do for a Witcher, they start a notice board. Appeal to Sir Geralt of Rivia. The bridge his crest. Geralt of Rivia, at the behest of our merciful sovereign, Her illustrious grace, Anna Henrietta. We have journeyed to the northern realms to lay before you our mission. A terrible monster has appeared in the duchy of Toussaint. a beast that has committed heinous crimes against her grace's subjects. Only the most famous among witchers has the ability to destroy the beast. Thus, we humbly beseech you to appear in the village of Holloway, where we shall await you in full hope that you will deign to hear our woes and liberate our land from the clutches of fear. Your humble servants, Sirs Palmerin de la Lanfell and Milton de Pirac-Piran, knights in the service of her grace and duchy. So it's to meet them at the... Meet the knights from Toussaint in Holloway. It's probably a ways off from here. Sounds like there's trouble afoot already.
Fear not.
But we've not got no need for your help.
Have no fear, good man. Our labors shall be done quickly. The prowlers to be banished for good.
Milton, look.
Geralt.
In the flesh.
Hail, Witcher. Let us go inside and greet you as befits an old friend.
And you, fear not. We shall put an end to the rule of outlaws soon.
Found your message on a notice board.
You see, Palmerin, I told you. The griffin at White Orchard. I knew that were we only to follow the tracks of its slayer, we would in the end find Geralt.
Milton de Peyrac-Peyrin and Palmerin de Longfor. Good to see you both. Been years.
Be assured, we share your joy.
You must forgive us our, surroundings. When we pledged to place the village under our protection, the village elder gave us this hut as our lodgings. He swore it is the best hut in the village.
Get involved in some squabble?
We discovered that in retreating, the Redanian garrison that left this land still is at the mercy of numerous plagues. A tyranny of bandits, the most onerous among them. These plunderers shall soon descend on this village to collect tribute. Milton and I will dissuade them.
We are both sworn to fight injustice and oppression wherever they rear their heads. The matter does not concern you, of course, but do us the kindness of waiting. Once we have dealt with these marauders, we have a matter we must present to you.
So, plan to go out and meet the bandits when they arrive? Fight them?
Palmerin wishes first to appeal to their sense of decency. But I expect they will be deaf to this.
Yeah, completely.
We must afford them a chance to stand down. Many a hardened outlaw has left the path of wrongdoing upon hearing words of admonition.
Doesn't happen in these lands. Ever.
If they do not heed my reprimand, we at least will know we have done all within our means to evade bloodshed.
Fine. Naturally, I'll help when Palmerin's rhetoric falls on deaf ears.
Excellent. Then we've but to wait for the rogues to arrive.
They are coming!
Hear that? Your bandits have arrived.
Let us go out to greet them.
He mean us?
Aye, Palmerin de Lawnfall, call upon you to repent. Search your hearts. Do you not see that they are blackened?
Regular punch and duty here.
To prey upon commoners is no honor. To loot their meager stores, abandon the path of shame, and we will spare you.
Right, good jest, that. Had us a laugh. Now, fuck off before we lose our patience and you lose something else.
Nay, wait, Zorg. These lads are a lark. Mayhaps they know some tricks.
Oi, players! Can you toss balls all loopity-like?
Or do that thing where one spits fire while the other farts.
I can spit fire.
Noble Palmerin's given you a chance. Now I'm gonna give you some advice. Do what he says.
Or what?
Or you'll find yourself fighting knights errant in the pay of the Duchess of Toussaint, and they eat scum like you with their morning porridge.
There's three of them. Two turtled up in armor. We'll come back later.
Some wench sent them. Folk who say we's afeard of wenches and jesters.
Ooh, insulted the Duchess. Not good.
Indeed, we cannot let the affront go unpunished. I swear upon the Heron you will pay with your own blood! By the crane, villains, ready your arms!
Alright, let's go make a mess of things. No, it's fine, I remember how to play. We'll be fine. Definitely fine.
Let's dance.
Where's the archer? There's an archer. Oop, don't want you doing what you do. Hey! Oh, he went down instantly. That was fast. Quen. There we go. Oh, he's level 2. That's adorable. He went down in one hit. Are these guys supposed to be really low level like this? Interesting. I'm just one-shotting them all. Okay. Well, this is a change of pace. They're just dissolving. I don't know if there's... It's supposed to be level 37 quest, I think. Or level 34 is the minimum. Kind of surprised by them being lower. I'm not exactly gonna get a lot of practice this way. Hi. Oh, missed. Got him.
Why do they not emerge? It is over. We have banished the scoundrels. Lifted oppression's yoke from their lives.
Warned you it'd be like this. Fear you as much as they did the bandits now. Sorry, no fanfares and flowers. You're not in Toussaint.
Ach, it is true what folk claim. In the north, no noble deed goes unthwarted. It is time to go home.
And we shall, my friend. Come, Geralt. It's time we delivered our message.
So fess up. What brings you such a long way?
We are to deliver Her Grace the Duchess's message in full, with all due ceremony. For tradition...
is sacred in Toussaint. All right, fine.
Most honorable Geralt, slayer of monsters and all evils nefarious, which prey on the defenseless of this world.
Whereas never have you been known to deny help to the innocent, nor leave widows and orphans to fates undeserved. Answer you now our present summons. Free us from the beast which floods our streets with blood and sows panic in the hearts of rich and poor alike. Come to our aid, Witcher.
Thus humbly beseeches you the star-crossed city's most gracious protectress, Her Illustrious Highness, Duchess Anna Henrietta.
Shall you answer her call?
Anna Henrietta really say all that? Word for word?
In point of fact, she said, bring me the Witcher and dare not spare your horses. Only make certain this time he comes alone. The Ducal Chamberlain added the rest. You know how it is.
Yeah, I remember.
I might add, be it unofficially, that a hefty reward awaits. Yet the specifics you will need to verify with Her Illustrious Highness.
Might be the most fervent request that I take a contract ever. And the most polite. And now we've got all that behind us. I want to hear more about this beast. Some kind of monster? Just guessing.
Most assuredly. Though no one has caught a good look at it as yet. Our only sure witnesses. The bodies massacred in a brutal, horrid manner.
Look. Some sketches drafted from descriptions given by those who claim they glimpsed the beast. Each quite different. To my mind, these witnesses lie.
How many victims so far?
Two. When Her Grace learnt of the second, she discharged us immediately to fetch you, promising grants of land and fortunes in gold, should you answer her summons.
An ill wind blows, Geralt. The beast cannot be tracked. Folks say it wields black magic. Also, Both victims were nobly born, and the start of a tourney draws near.
Those are awfully specific victims. Makes you wonder if maybe it's they're targeted in somehow. I believe they said that the descriptions are inconsistent.
Mentioned a tourney. Why doesn't the Duchess just call it off?
Simply, it is too late. The guests have arrived. The best knights of all lands, relatives of the Emperor.
The beast could be a threat to others, not just to Her Grace's subjects.
Got it. Before an aristocrat dies, at best it's a scandal. At worst, a diplomatic incident. Beast wields black magic? What makes you say so?
The first victim vanished between bites at a feast. Of the feastgoers, none noticed this. They saw but an open window, then heard desperate cries from the street below, where a corpse had just been found.
The second killing, similar. A knight in a locked room. Servants all about the house. Guards all around the estate. Yet the beast somehow got him out, dragged him to the town square, and killed him there. No one saw nor heard a thing.
We have no fear of creatures against which sword and shield protect. But of this beast, nothing is known. Save that it cannot be traced, kills effortlessly, and with no rhyme or reason we can discern.
Almost sounds like teleportation.
Anyone tried to hunt it? Knights errant, for example?
Ha! Many have tried. Baiting, waiting in ambush, but to no avail. The beast is clever. It evades all traps and attacks of a sudden. It is like a ghost.
An experienced tracker. This is what we need, with knowledge of monsters. In short, we need you.
I sometimes think back to all the contracts I've ever taken from sovereigns. Can't name hardly any where I came out ahead.
You cannot be thinking to refuse.
No. Just struck by a thought. How the Duchess can sometimes be... demanding.
So you accept the contract? Excellent!
We must set off at once. We long wanted this land searching for you. Yet time is of the essence.
Ready to go, soon as you're packed.
Ha! Then post haste to Toussaint.
To Toussaint! Toussaint, the land of love and wine.
Exactly how I remembered it.
You will find Beauclair has changed some these past years.
Walk about when you have the chance. You will see for yourself.
To me, place always seemed straight out of a fairy tale. Knights errant, elven palaces.
You insinuate that we are somehow odd? I shall prove you wrong. This I pledge on the Heron.
Oh my god, I love how colorful it all is already. Nice. Alright. Get Quinn out of the way real quick. Whoa! How you feeling, buddy? Oh, no. Not a big fan of the proximity. If you could just like, keep your distance a little bit. Oh! Hey! Look at the range he's got on that. Not a big fan, honestly. You keep your hands to yourself a little bit. He's not very interested in everybody else here, is he? He's probably feeble of mind. What if I did a little bit... That's the wrong one. Yeah. A little axie.
Oh!
I don't know if it worked. He was a little in the middle of attack. I think it said slow down, so it probably did something. Alright. Here it comes again. He's a big, friendly guy, if you haven't noticed. Shockwave. Let's put a few slowing things down. I think I can put down two of them at once. Just one? I am noticing that the colorfulness of the environment is making it a little hard to tell where exactly my attack is. Oh. Gotta get into the rhythm of things a little bit. Hey, buddy. How you feeling? Just thought I'd put a few holes in you real quick. He gets it. He's okay with it. It's fine. We're friends. Oh! Okay, he was not a fan, as it turns out. I may have exaggerated our relationship. Hey? A little more fire? A little more fire? Yeah, he likes it. It's fine. Oh. I was going to try to heal a little bit, but I don't know if I really want to try to heal with Quinn on this guy. Hey, buddy. You're at, like half down now. It's all fine. Oh. How about that attack now? Hopefully not going to fall for that twice. I was going to just say it with certainty, but then I realize I'm me. Oh. So, I'm interestingly, the adrenaline point thing has become a weird little meter. And I think it even shows you progress towards the generation of the next point by slowly filling it in. Whereas it used to just kind of show up out of the blue, which is interesting. This is a bad place to be. Did not know I was going into a dead end. Thankfully, like many enemies, this one is flammable. Nope, 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 nope. Not planning on hanging out in that neighborhood over there. You can keep it to yourself, honestly. Huh? So I believe at the moment adrenaline points actually revive my character if he goes down. Hey. No need for that kind of misconduct around here. Hit. Just be chill. Alright, McQuinn's down. Oh, here comes the spittin'! He's a big, nice, friendly fella. Just needs some burnin' lovin'. Mostly from fire. There we go, that's probably it. Maybe not? Yeah. He broke that windmill. You know how hard those are to make back now? Whenever this is?
Big beast. Tackling it single-handed? None too wise.
Neither is love born of wisdom, Witcher. So, Guillaume, out with it. Which fair damsel inspired you to vow to kill that filth?
The most beautiful among them.
If he wishes to guard her name a secret, he need not reveal it.
You I do not know, sir, nor seem you a knight, yet still I am profoundly grateful, nay, indebted to you for your succor. This trophy, sir, is yours.
I've never quite heard someone in Witcher sound so Canadian.
A giant this close to human settlements? Strange.
Well, that was no ordinary giant. His name was Goliath, rumored to have been a knight once, but one who broke his vows. For this, the Lady of the Lake transformed him into a wild giant and banished him into the Gorgon Hills.
So he came back down? Why?
Several times each year, hunger chased him into the lowlands. Goliath had killed and devoured many shepherds. Guillaume's hunt served a noble cause. At any rate, it's a tale for more agreeable environs.
I'll take the trophy. Why not? Could find someone who'll pay to buy it. Put up a good fight against the giant. Got experience battling monsters?
None. In Toussaint, we mostly chase bandits. But I vowed I'd bring my heart's champion the head of a monstrosity, as the famed Gottfried, known as the Giant Killer, did.
You don't mean to hunt the beast, I hope. The matter's best left to Geralt.
Another challenge awaits me. Yet if Geralt is to hunt the beast, he ought to know. It struck again.
The river surrendered a corpse. It washed up in the meander by the cockatrice. Damien Delatour's guardsmen are there already, securing the area.
Securing the area? Better go there now before they trample any tracks, manhandle any evidence.
Set forth, then. I shall ride for the city to inform her gracious magnificence that Geralt has arrived. We'll meet later, near Guillaume's tent at the Tourney grounds. I shall take you then to see her grace.
Everything about this location is so wonderfully beautiful so far. It's great. Look at these sweeping colors. I guess this might be our temporary reprieve from the, let's call it the grime of the Northern Realms, is what I'd call it. Here we go. Now we've got three major regions to explore.
That's it, Roach.
Northern Realms, Scoia'tael, and, is Scoia'tael the right name? Yeah, I think it is. And, in this place, Toussaint. Alright, Milton, tell me where this body is. He said it washed by cockatrice.
Brave kid, Guillaume.
Palmerin oversaw his upbringing. Guillaume is his kin.
Why are we talking about? In Blood and Wine, you can undergo additional Witcher mutations to unlock new capabilities. Soon you will run into a messenger who will deliver a very interesting letter. Read it, and investigate the story of Professor Moreau to learn more about these mutations. They say a master craftsman lives in Toussaint who can craft Witcher gear of unequaled quality. What's more, you can receive special bonuses for wearing all or part of a set of this extraordinary equipment. You will not regret investigating in these new options. So it sounds like I can get a new armor set and new abilities. Interesting. Any follow-up, sir? So it said cockatrice. Is there just like a local cockatrice you guys just don't do anything about? That sounds like a hazard. Ooh. Look at these colors. It reminds me of exploring parts of The Witness.
Can't get used to the way you knights talk. Especially how you switch back and forth between flowery and, well, near normal.
We are knights errant, in the service of her gracious magnificence. When we appear in her name or speak on her behalf, we are bound by tradition.
And it won't be tiring at all.
Not so fast,
Here we go.
They must have removed the body already.
Let's look around, make sure they didn't miss anything.
The body's gone already, that doesn't help me. What can we find?
Hobnailed boots, multiple sets of prints. Ducal guard, clearly. Let's see where they went.
Alright.
Walked along the shoreline.
Perhaps the body lay on the bank.
Our tracking capabilities continue. What are we gonna find? Whole path. Oh, hi. Level 40s? That's rough. Alright, we'll see how it goes. What are these? Friend? Of course, it's never friend. Why can't it ever be friend? Just once. Why must we fight? I see you. Yeah. Oh, okay, I was gonna say you're not gonna catch me off guard, but then they slap me in the face, so... That's what I get for saying anything. Okay. Prefer if we weren't in the water. But maybe Igni will work anyway. In the face. How's that fire working out for- Ooh, they are flammable as all hell. And down. Ah, it feels good. Oh, they deserve all of- Ooh, they explode. Noteworthy things to keep in mind. Okay. Couldn't quite read their names, they're moving too fast. I'm missing playing on PC a little bit because this TV seems to blur the names a little bit. You guys might be able to read them better than I can. Here we go. Whoops. For the record, my Witcher series originally dates to me having a much less capable PC, so it made sense to play this on PlayStation 4, but I would happily be playing on PC right now if it wasn't the whole, like, continued save thing. If any hint of the main story leaks into any part of this one, I want it to be true to what happened originally. Or it'll feel really wrong to me. Melt for me. Hey, you broke the melting. Stop hitting him. He'll melt. It's cool. See? It's easy. Ooh! That hit me from really far away.
By the smell of blood. Let's keep looking.
I'm impressed by the range of that explosion. That's pretty far away. Those limbs are floating now. Hello. Things really are weird in this new world of ours. Strange new continent of floating limbs and nightmares. I should loot their bodies a bit. They're necrophages. So I was looking at this little pile of stuff.
Anything taken by the current ends up in these shallows.
Yes, the stench is fierce.
Junk that came down the river.
We must keep searching.
I was trying to look at the loot. There we go. Oh. Probably not entirely worthwhile. It's fine. Drink a swallow real quick for to get caught back up on health. Hey.
Only blood-soaked scraps left of the victim's clothing. Good quality cloth.
A wealthy victim, correct?
Looks it.
They seem to all be wealthy victims. So it makes it seem... the fact that there's a trend between the targets makes it seem like there's an intelligent design behind this, that someone's actually conspiring. And the fact that there's a tourney coming up makes me wonder, like, are we going to find out all these people are taking part?
Footprints. See them? And a rut made by the hull of a boat. Left recently, I'd say.
Might be a little hard to follow a boat. Am I expected to follow that with my Witcher senses?
Dragged some nets onto the bank, then cut them to untangle them. Lot of blood, so the corpse must have been cut up. Quartered, maybe.
It's likely they loaded the body parts onto a boat and sailed off.
It'd make it easier to carry, I suppose. Also creepy.
Gonna dive in, check the other nets. Nets were attached here.
Oh, we're gonna find another piece of body down here? Yeah, I'm wondering if somebody's trying to rig the competition by eliminating the other members of it. We'll find out soon. I'm sure sooner or later it'll come up that they may or may not all be participants. That's probably a limb, right? Just some linen? Okay. Not as noteworthy as I expected. Oop, down here. That's a spoon. How exciting. We can really hold our breath down here. Oh. That seems rather noteworthy. There's oars. What do we have? There's another oar. Let's go ahead and surface before I drown down here. Come on. Come on, slightly awkward swimming. There we go. There's something. What am I missing? Oh, that seems awfully important. DLC.
Silk kerchief. Monogrammed DLC. A noble's accessory, clearly. Be nice to know where they took the corpse.
Interesting touch, having a bunch of noise around than one important object. Making it actually feel like a search.
What now?
This isn't the site of the murder. We know that. Current brought the body here. Corpse got caught in the nets. Guardsmen pulled it out, put it in a boat and took it somewhere. Need to find out where. I'd like to look at the corpse before it starts to decompose.
The inn. Its patrons must have seen the guardsmen, which direction they took. We should ask there.
Seems we've got ourselves an audience.
You think this surprising? The locals will tell the children of children they do not have yet of the day a quartered corpse was pulled from the river.
One thing. Found a handkerchief in the water. Monogrammed DLC. Mean anything to you?
Delacroix? It cannot be. Was it he the beast slew?
Seems so. Knew him well?
Long past. We were close friends once, but our paths diverged. He was a man of extremes, standing by his companions no matter the odds, fighting his foes to the bitter end.
Foes? You have a lot of them?
He did, but I do not see what that has to do with the beast. Ah, Geralt, you've struck a raw nerve. Memories of a time long past, to which I'd rather not return now.
I understand. We can talk later. Let's go to the tavern.
I shall have to leave you soon. Return to court.
Barely got back to Toussaint.
A knight in the service of Her Illustrious Highness knows no rest. In fact, I feared I would return too late to fulfill my duty. Yet it seems I've arrived in the nick of time.
I think CD Projekt Red just made fun of the rest of AAA gaming there by having a character who was ripped into shreds and separated piece by piece, quartered as they say it, and his name is DLC.
Once you're finished examining the corpse, be sure to report to Anarieta.
Anarieta?
Her Grace, the Duchess. I forget myself at times. We address each other by our first names in private. Never in Pomeran's presence, however.
He finds such familiarity offensive.
Keep calm!
A watering hole for traders, smugglers, boatmen. But you will find no better crayfish chowder in all Toussaint!
There's been an ongoing thing for a while where all sorts of games come out and it feels like their main content's divided into a bunch of DLC chapters and it compromises the experience that they're trying to convey. And Witcher 3 is very much not that, because they have a complete game and then these huge expansions that are utterly divorced from the main content to make it clear that they're additional new stuff that they worked on separately. So that's... yeah, DLC seems like an actual jab at the rest of gaming. We don't make DLC here at CD Projekt Red, we make expansions. And we earn the word.
By my troth! Could that be the musty scent of fresh pate?
Naught else, Sir de Peyrac Peyren. I see time has not dulled your senses.
We would be honored if you would join us. Your companion as well.
But why do I not detect even a whiff of crayfish chowder?
No soup today, on account of there being no crayfish. I reckon you've not heard, but all I caught was a corpse. I awoke at the crack of dawn, as I do each day. But when I looked up, I beheld a blood-red sky.
This corpse is precisely why we're here. For the man whom you've invited to join you at the table was summoned from a far-off land by her gracious magnificence. He is tasked with tracking and killing the beast.
We invited two men to join us, yet since Sir de Peyrac Peyren in temperament is more akin to hare than hound, I surmise the other is the hunter. With whom do we have the pleasure?
Name's Geralt.
A humble introduction. You've clearly not tarried long with Sir de Peyrac Peyren.
Spare us the petty insults. Geralt is a master of the witchering trade. He has questions concerning the beast's last victim.
I was the one to find the corpse. The sun had just risen when I awoke, sat straight up in my bed, looked out the window, and beheld a sky red as blood.
Ask Geralt, please, or we shall be here till winter.
Must have been early in the morning. Went to check your nets and then...
I stepped out of my hut and saw...
By my troth, to the point, man! You found a body ensnared in your crayfish nets. We know this already. What happened then? Did you see anyone nearby? Did you spy anything noteworthy? Anything at all?
Not a soul around, just me. As for noteworthy... well...
What did you see? But be warned, if I hear the sky was red again...
I saw a head bobbing, eyes bulging. The tongue blew and popped out. Next to it, a hand rocking upon the water.
Get a good look at the body parts?
They gave me such a fright. I bolted to town fast as my legs would take me, then returned with guardsmen who told me to keep out of their way. They had a hard haul. The parts were so tangled up in my nets, they were forced to cut them.
Need to examine the body. Know where they took it?
They ferried it across, then loaded it on a cart and hauled it to a cellar at Corfo Bianco to keep it cool, see?
What? Why, Corfo Bianco is Baron Rossell's estate. When he learns they've turned his cellar into a morgue, he'll set his hounds on them.
While you were gallivanting about the north, his vineyard was auctioned off.
Who was that woman who just left? Didn't see her before. Didn't notice her walk in, either.
Doubtless Linus, the innkeep's daughter. But hold, Geralt, because this is an outrage. Rossell's vineyard was auctioned off? Inconceivable!
It is no secret the Baron had gambling debts up to his ears. It finally came time to collect. His creditors auctioned off his property. The Ducal Chancellery bought it, in fact. Rossell now bunks with his brother in Vico Faro.
I told Rossell he'd get his comeuppance. How long can one draw on past heroics? His creditors must finally have defined that his promises meant nothing.
Such are the times. Today's knights are pale shadows of the heroes of yore.
It's true what they say. God sent the beast to punish us for straying from the old paths.
so folk think the beast's divine punishment.
Knights have turned their backs on the old customs. Where they were defenders of the duchy, they're now defenders of their own tushes.
Why, you insolent?
Let him talk.
The Duchess trades in titles, grants honors to ill doers. We've strayed from the path of virtue, lost the gods' favor, so the gods sent retribution.
Don't listen to that nonsense, Geralt. It's rehashed street preacher codswallop.
Yes, the rebel rousers have been sprouting up like weeds lately, each offering the same bill of goods.
They say anything else about the beast, besides it being a messenger of the gods?
The Toussaint are no fools. They see clearly the beast kills on days honoring patron saints.
Picky monster.
Definitely further encourages the idea of it not being a monster or something intelligent like a vampire of some kind.
Thanks for the hospitality. Time I examined the corpse.
Covo Bianco lies a short way from here, near the tourney grounds. Just follow the road and you'll arrive.
Not coming with? Oh yeah, duty of some sort calls.
Some sort? Her Grace bestowed a great honor on me, even before we departed for Velen. I'm to play the hare during this year's game in the palace gardens. When you see me in my costume, you will wet yourself laughing.
A little tempted to ask a few questions, but it sounds like a long, complicated story. One involving lengthy digressions into local history and tradition. So, see you later, Milton, and good luck.
Oh, such a tease. I want to see him in his bunny costume. Alright, so the stage is set. There's a mysterious monster that's attacking, but there's patterns both in who's being attacked and when they get attacked. There's patterns in how they're killed. We're in a beautiful new land that we haven't gotten to see, at least not in this game. And we have the suggestion of holy retribution and a class divide in this area. I'm looking forward to it. I think I'm going to go ahead and cut the first episode here, guys. Thanks for watching, like always, and hey, if you haven't picked up on that already, you can check at the top of the description of the video. There is a playlist you can see that'll show you all the videos for the main playthrough, all the videos for the first expansion, and all videos for this expansion will also be in there as they come out. Hopefully I can finish this before we hit the 200 episode cap, which I think playlists still cap out at 200. Also, it's kind of funny that when we're coming in here, Geralt referred to this place as something that reminds him of fairy tales. As if every other enemy in this entire game isn't some kind of weird fairy tale land. We met the seven dwarves, kind of. Anyway, see you guys next time.